We are surrounded. A ring of spears pointing inward from the edges of our system. The Black Fleet could have destroyed us, and yet they have waited. Why? Savathun knows more than she lets on. It is the only reason she still lives, and she is keenly aware of that fact. It is why Zeebo Arath pursues her so relentlessly. For Zeebo Arath answers to the same entity as the Black Fleet. We must uncover whatever secrets she knows with the time that we have. I must reiterate, she will try to betray us. It is all that a wretched, self-serving creature like Savathun knows how to do. She needs me to free herself of her worm, but after that... The blind well requires alignment. As you rescue my remaining Tekians, continue your audiences with her. How did Mies Rax put it? We must all learn to live alongside our monsters. Though I suppose he never said for how long.
Petra, it's Ikora Rey. I thought now would be a good time to check in.
Things are progressing as well as can be expected, given the circumstances. While we've recovered some of the lost Tekians, we still don't have everyone we need to separate Savathun from her worm.
Understood. Don't rush this on Mike. I don't care what she wants. This needs to be done with as minimal risk to your people as possible.
I know you hope that this will lead you to Osiris. But you want my opinion? Osiris is already dead. Savathun is a creature of lies. She has no honor.
Your opinion is noted. And on the subject of opinions, House Crow.
You want my take? On him? In a word, vulnerable. But Queen Mara refuses to send him away. Though, you could.
Trust is a delicate thing, Petra. I don't want to lose his. This is important to him. I trust Crow to make the right choices, and for you to protect him from himself if he doesn't.
I'm noticing dimensional distortions in your ghost's readings. A beacon should be nearby. I'm detecting beacon alignment, but there are enemies closing on your position. Thank you.
Now we know what Zeebu Arath was planning for her Wrathborn armies. She intends to conquer the Ascendant Plane.
Thank you. detecting beacon alignment. But there are enemies closing on your position.
Thank you.
own. The Scorn stage some sort of ritual combat. This is not a Volixne culture. Are they developing their own? Remove these vermin. Harvesting ascendant energy with such simple brute force. They must be stopped.
It appears these decaying vermin have discovered a means to refine ascendant energy.
The dark intellect of the Scorn is a cruel reflection of their former lives as Elixni. But to have reverse-engineered a process to refine ascendant energy, they could not have done this on their own. Scorn appeared to be in the early stages of developing some form of trial by combat. I'm reminded of your crucible, Guardian. Mockeries of life, sloughing off the skin of their former culture. If the Scorn are learning, changing, what are they becoming?
Last beacon aligned. Be ready for anything.
Thank you.
Excellent work, Guardian. We couldn't have done it without you.
Taken, Scorn, the Hive. Our true enemies aligned to a spearhead to halt our rescues of the Tekkians.
No mention of House Salvation or the Cabal?
House Salvation is in ruins. You saw to that. As for the Cabal, I am not worried about Empress Keitel. She and I will see eye to eye one day. But Kallus...
I agree. Kallus is a problem. We should discuss what the Vanguard found aboard the Glycon. In private.
When this is over, I wonder if Mara will uphold her end of the bargain and let me live. Killing me is probably at the top of your to-do list as well, isn't it? You've done a lot of killing over the years. Let me ask you something. Of all the enemies you've fought, how many saw your ghost and realized, that's why Guardians are so strong? Not most, but some. They might have even taken a shot at it. R.I.P. Cade. Now, how many saw beyond your ghost? How many followed the line of your light straight back to the Traveler? And how many knew enough to aim a weapon there? A few. The smart ones. The dangerous ones. You'd recognize their names. Listen to me now. Look beyond me to my worm. Look beyond my worm to something far, far worse. Then look down at that little gun in your hand and tell me. What do you think you're going to do with that thing?
Thank you.
Once more, we part the curtain of reality, and you step beyond. With each ley line we restore, we get closer to our lost Tekkians.
And Zebu Arath's army gets closer to us.
Let's go. before he was Krogh, was looking for Mara. Could he have used the ley lines to find her?
No. When he turned, he lost all focus. Rumor is he thought he was being guided by her toward the end.
Could he have willed her image into being somehow?
Whatever happened, I think it's more complex than that.
with each ley line we restore, we get closer to our lost Tekkians.
And Zebu Arath's army gets closer to us.
Thank you.
to describe the way the spider treated Crow in a single word, what word would that be?
Well, the spider is a valued member of the Shore's ecosystem. I wouldn't want to offend.
The spider is not here.
Well, I would say... horrible. He was horrible. He tortured Crow, demeaned him, treated him like a possession.
That's enough. I have all the confirmation I need.
Mobilizing fire team for operation, baby dog. Why does this say baby dog? I must have forgotten to reboot the strike name generator.
Operation baby dog? Well, it has a certain ring to it, huh?
Yes, baby dog. Well, the strike protocol is already running. Can't stop it now. Devrim?
One of my teams reported Taken energy infecting the water supply. Our purification tech can only do so much. If the contamination spreads, people will die.
Taken fog cleared up as soon as the blight went down.
If the blights can be killed, then perhaps their infection can be reversed. You lot are going to save lives today.
I'm still tracking Taken energy nearby. They're all over the water facility. And under it. Whatever's behind this must be underground. If the Taken wanted to poison the entire Dead Zone, this was the place to do it. They didn't pick it by accident.
If they succeed, we won't have room on the farm. We're still treating wounded from the Red War. It won't come to that.
Taken energy is spiking. This is it. Taken compromised a Red Legionary. It would explain how organized they've been. Without Oryx, I didn't think they could still, well, take.
Guardian, Hive forces are lashing out from the Cosmodrome, led by a disgraced wizard named Devota.
Disgraced?
She narrowly escaped a previous Vanguard operation with her life. Now the Brood questions her strength.
She'll be desperate to prove herself.
Indeed. That desperation makes her dangerous, but also reckless. Eliminate her before she regains her footing.
Lots of movement ahead. Be ready for anything. Fallen raiding party ahead. They don't seem thrilled about Nevota's presence.
They won't appreciate yours either.
I'm reading dense Hive signatures in a facility up ahead. I don't like this. It feels like a trap.
Then spoil their plans.
Close now. She won't escape this time.
Retreat isn't an option for her anymore. Not with the Brood doubting her. Expect the worst, Guardian. Nevota has no choice but to defeat you.
That energy signature. that's her. That's Navota.
Navota's play for power showed the danger in Hive logic, but also its flaws. You've proven that the path to victory comes only from the light.
We're happy to send the message, Commander.
Excellent work. Return to the tower.
Perhaps a barter is warranted.
Checking. Transfer. Sign, please.
I can't believe how good that hunter looked in the crucible last night.
Greetings. Farewell.
Tell you, I know the problem.
I swear, if you get sucked into a jet turbine, I'm gonna... Heya! Wish I'd had that years ago. Catch you later.
We're here, stranger.
We're not strangers anymore, little light. You can call me Elsie. Or Elizabeth. Whatever works.
Okay. Elizabeth it is. But I prefer Ghost. So, what's our plan?
Despite our best efforts, the Vex Gate within remains active thanks to Aramis.
We're here, stranger.
Destroying it loses us a vital link to the Vex. A story for another time, perhaps. We're not strangers anymore, little light. You can call me Elsie. Or Elizabeth. Whatever works. For now, we need to focus on stopping any further incursions from the portal.
Understood. We'll take care of it. So, what's our plan?
Despite our best efforts, the Vex Gate within remains active thanks to Aramis. Destroying it loses us a vital link to the Vex. A story for another time, perhaps. For now, we need to focus on stopping any further incursions from the portal.
Understood. We'll take care of it. Here we are again, cleaning up another of Clovis Bray's messes.
I'm sure wherever he is, he's laughing at us. He's the reason all this is here in the first place. The darkness told him to build the portal. It's his fault the Vex invaded. His fault so many people died. I did everything I could to help. It still wasn't enough.
There's no use in quantifying the help you give. Any amount is enough. You've done far more than most.
And it's only just begun, little light.
Thank you. reach the portal.
You know what to do.
That's the last of them, Elizabeth.
Good riddance, evil bastards. Until next time.
cruisers keep returning to Nibble.
Thank you.
Zivu Arath's subordinate came to my doorstep as a thief. Their death is the price of encroachment. Agar's scepter carves pathways toward one's goals. The compass you carry is based off the same principles as this weapon. In Uldren's hands, it could have connected every edge of my kingdom. Through Zivu Arath, it would grant an omnipresence within the reef even I could not subdue. Deliver it safely to me. While it may never be Uldren's, it may yet serve to guide what he has become.
So you wish to hear the rest of my brother's story? Fine. I will oblige you. When the storm came, Riga and Agar rode the winds to meet it. A fleet of talons at their back. A great battle ensued. The storm took, as was its nature. Many fell, Agar among them. Riga could only watch as he tumbled down, 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 until her heart beat alone. She dove into the storm, giving herself to destroy it. Riga's spirit ascended higher into the sky, where she hoped to reunite with her brother. Instead, she met the thing that sent the storm. A bottomless well of grief, unreachable by reasoning, or bargaining, or violence. A voice in the darkness. And so, Riga gathered her feathers into an aegis of wings to shield the world below. But over the years, feathers broke away. Futility wore thin her resolve. Then, one day, her heart began to beat as it once had, doubled, distant, but different. A beautiful echo. Hope called her home. And though she prayed to find Agar there, he never returned. I still feel Uldren's heartbeat somewhere out there. When your crow first stood in my halls, I saw an ember of my Uldren burning in his breast. Curiosity and a sibling fondness told me I could stoke that ember. I hope it is not a lie. I hope he is more than the last ebb of hot ash from a long dead flame. Many of his faults were not of his own making. Uldren's decisions were his, of course, but driven by whips in the hands of others. Myself included. I will have to offer him more than an old story of an empty promise if I wish to see that ember burn again. This is the path I led Uldren down. If certain actors had kept to their roles, I would have wielded Uldrensov, Lightbearer. But even Marasov cannot control everyone. I celebrate his resurrection in the light. But I detest seeing my brother rewritten, his greater self sloughed away and swept into the cellar. There is still good to draw from who he was. Don't squander it. He needs a star to guide him. Uldren or Crow, they are the same in that regard. Agur's scepter is yours, then, both its burden and the freedom it can provide. Be careful with it, Guardian. He is prone to devotion.
Align the beacons, Guardian, and signal the way home.
You're making good progress. I believe that's another beacon ahead. Detecting beacon alignment, but there are enemies closing on your position. I've never seen the Taken, Scorn, and Hive coordinate like this before. It's troubling. Get aligned. They'll have felt that. Be ready.
Come on.
Scorn staged some sort of ritual combat. This is not a Valixni culture. Are they developing their own? Remove these vermin. Harvesting ascendant energy with such simple brute force. They must be stopped. Thank you.
These Scorn appeared to be in the early stages of developing some form of trial by combat. I'm reminded of your Crucible, Guardian. Mockeries of life, sloughing off the skin of their former culture. If the Scorn are learning, changing, what are they becoming? It appears these decaying vermin have discovered a means to refine ascendant energy. This is a Corsair wayfinding cache. Information on their search for me through the ruins of this place. To imagine my Corsairs looked for me, even here. That they gave their lives while searching through these crooked plains. A queen would not be humbled. I will add their sacrifice to the weight I already bear. The dark intellect of the Scorn is a cruel reflection of their former lives as Elixni. But to have reverse-engineered a process to refine ascendant energy, they could not have done this on their own.
Thank you. Thank you. Oops.
This data cache was left by one of my Tekkions after the Battle of Saturn. It bears my name. She was trying to reach me through the power of her will. She entered this plane and summoned me. And she succeeded, after a fashion. Rest. Your queen has heard your call. This cache holds record of the Harbingers, ancient weapons we set to bear against the Hive God Oryx. When we attacked Oryx's dreadnought, three Tekians and I set the Harbingers upon him. It took all our powers to call forth weapons of such impossible destruction, all for naught. Now his sister awaits me, lingering in her crystal coffin. A move against her will not succeed if guided by force alone.